Good afternoon everyone. In this video we are going to discuss the frame assisted ultrasonic spray pyrolysis as well as gas condensation processing, chemical vapor processing we are going to discuss over here. So first we are going to discuss the frame assisted ultrasonic spray pyrolysis. So mainly this method it can be used to produce industrial powders, okay, to manufacturing that it can be used over here. It is used to producing the powder in the large quantities like a carbon black as well as a fumed silica and titanium oxide. So for that purpose this frame assisted ultrasonic spray pyrolysis is used over here. So in this process, so mainly the precursors are nebulized and then unwanted components are burnt in the flame to get the required materials. So example here is the zirconium oxide has been obtained by the method from precursors of zirconium. So flame hydrolysis, that is a variant of this process, is used for manufacture of fused silica. So in the process, silicon tetrachloride is heated in an oxyhydrogen flame to give the highly dispersed silica, and the resulting with white amorphous powder consists of spherical particles with sizes in the range of 7 to 40 nanometer. So the combustion flame synthesis, in which the burning of a gas mixture, so example acetylene and oxygen or hydrogen and oxygen, supplies the energy to initiate the pyrolysis of the precursor compounds, is widely used in the industrial production of the powder over here. Okay, so here the thing is, once the component are there, so once the, we can heat it up, it will be converted into the fog, so that goes into the droplet of containing precursor. So what is the meaning of the precursor? Means a substance from which another is formed, especially by a metabolic reaction. So that is called as precursor. So it will be formed into the cluster, then we are going to get the nanomaterial over here. The basic idea of a low pressure combustion flame synthesis is to extend the pressure range of the pressure used gas phase synthesis, and thus it reduces the to or avoid the agglomeration. To low pressure flames have been extensively used aerosol scientists to study particle formation in the flame over here. Then a key for the formation of nanoparticles with narrow size distribution is the exact control of the flame in order to obtain the flame front. Under these conditions, the thermal history, time, temperature of each particle formed is identical and narrow distribution result. So due to the oxidation of atmosphere in the flame, so this synthesis process is limited to the formation of oxides and the reactor zone. Next we are going to see the gas condensation processing technique. So in the gas condensation processing technique, the metallic or inorganic material, so example like suboxide is vaporized using the thermal evaporation sources such as crucible electron beam evaporation devices or sputtering sources in an atmosphere of 1 to 50 mm bar of helium, we can use like argon, neon, krypton, these are all the things. And while atmosphere 1 to 50 mm bar, the cluster form in the vicinity of the source of homogeneous nucleation in the gas phase and grow by cold skin and incorporation of atoms from the gas phase. Here the cluster particles depends critically on the residence time of the particle in the growth system, and it can be influenced by the gas pressure, the kind of inert gas like helium, argon and krypton, so and on the evaporation vapor pressure of the evaporating material. So with the increasing gas pressure, vapor pressure and mass of the inert gas used to average particle size of the nanoparticle, it increase. So log normal size distribution have been found experimentally and have been explained theoretically by the growth mechanism particles. Even more complex processes such as the low pressure combustion flame synthesis, where a number of chemical reactions are involved, the size distributions are determined to be log normal. So originally the rotating cylindrical device is cooled with the liquid nitrogen was employed for the particle collections. The nanoparticles in the size range from 2 to 50 nanometers are ejected from the gas flow thermophoretic forces and deposited loosely on the surface of the collection devices as powder, low density and no agglomeration. Subsequently, the nanoparticles are removed from the surface of the cylinder by means of scraper in the form of metallic plate over here. So in addition to this finger device, several techniques known from aerosol science have now been implemented for the gas in gas condensation system such as corona discharge, etc. So this method allow to continuous operation of collection devices and are better suited for larger scale synthesis of nano powder. Okay, so here also it will be similar to same like a furnace method. So I'll heat it up with the use of some of the heating element. So the component is evaporated, the cluster is formed over here. So while moving over in the scraper, it is formed as a nano particles over here. Okay, so this is about the gas condensation form. So while going to over here, the condensation it will be takes place. Okay, so due to that it will be colder and it will be formed as a particles. Next we are going to discuss the chemical vapor condensation technique. So in the chemical vapor condensation technique, as shown in the figure, the evaporative source used in the GPC is replaced by the hot wall reactor in the chemical vapor condensation. So here it will be depending upon the process parameter, nucleation and nanoparticle absorbed during the chemical vapor deposition of thin films and poses a major problems in obtaining good film qualities. So the original idea of this chemical vapor condensation process which is shown in the figure. So here it was intended into the adjust the parameter field during the synthesis in order to support the film over here. The formation and enhance the homogeneous nucleation of particles in the gas flow, it is readily found to found the residence time to precursors reactor determine the film particles are formed in a certain range of residence time both particles and the film formation can be obtained over here. So adjusting the residence time and the precursor molecules by changing the gas flow rate, so the pressure difference between the precursor delivery system and the main chamber occurs, the temperature of the hot wall reactor results the fertile production of nano sized particles of metals on ceramic instead of thin films as CVD process. So in the simplest form of metal organic precursor introduced in the hot zone of the reactor using the mass flow controller. Besides the increased quantities of this continuous process demonstrated that wide range of ceramic including nitrides and carbides can be synthesized. Additionally, more complex oxides such as barium, titanium oxides or composite structures can be formed as well. Okay. So appropriate precursors compounds can be readily found in CVD. The extension of the production of nanoparticles requires determination of modified parameters to field in order to promote the particle formation instead of film formation. Okay. So the CVC is the single precursors. The reactor allows the synthesis mixture of nanoparticles of two phases or doped nanoparticles by supplying two precursors at the front end of the reactor. And the coated nanoparticles, zirconium oxide coated with aluminum oxide by supplying a second precursor at second stage of reactor. So the homogeneous nucleation of coated by heterogeneous and nucleation of the second store of the reactor. Okay, so this is about the chemical vapor condensation. Thank you.